this is a very special occasion, is that this is the centennial year of this great institution, and I'm so proud, and at the same time I'm thankful to Allah Ta'ala for providing me with this distinction of leading the institution in its centennial year. Sir, you may recall that the government of Pakistan has recognized the contribution of this institution, has issued commemorative coin and stamp on the centennial and the foundation day of NED University. We had celebrated this event in our city campus, and a few dignitaries were invited only because of the COVID restrictions. Sir, I must report here that the entire world and us also have gone through a very difficult time, and we still are not out of it yet. We were caught by the pandemic completely, we were unaware. However, by the grace of God, I am so proud to tell you that not a single academic day was lost because of our proper planning and the support from the entire staff and the faculty, and a lot of contribution from the students. Even though I must say that some of them have become very intelligent and resourceful during the online examination. Sir, this institution is a wonderful institution, and it is probably one of the oldest institutions in the country which has created an impact in the city, in the province, in the country, and globally also. You are yourself is a witness to the some of the illustrious alumnus who have made the mark globally in different parts of the world. Sir, I must mention here that we are the largest or one of the largest in engineering institution in the country, and with a total enrolled strength of 11,986. That's yet another distinction, and all of you were part of it. Sir, we have also had a distinction of awarding the largest number of PhD in a year by any engineering institution in the country. The part of the convocation took place in the morning, and 18 PhDs were awarded. So this institution has 19 undergraduate programs, 49 postgraduate programs, and 19 doctoral programs, and today 1,905 undergraduate degrees will be conferred. And in Section 1, 868 masters and 18 PhD degrees have already been conferred here. Sir, this institution has grown and has widened its wings. And now, apart from offering degrees in engineering, we offer degrees in applied sciences and management and linguistics as well, so as to fill the gap of human resources which this country badly needs. Sir, very recently we have completed first phase of our sports facility by the support of the government of Sindh, a tremendous support, and now I'm so proud to mention that we have some of the finest sports facilities in the country. Not only in an educational institution, sir, for which I'm grateful to you and the government of Sindh for tremendous support, sir. Sir, I would also like to mention here that despite of difficult times of COVID, the support from the governments, the support from the alumni, and the support from the philanthropists has been of tremendous support to us. And last year, we were able to disperse a scholarship of worth 165 million to 2,000 plus students. And that is the testimony of the confidence that the donors have in the system that exists in the NED University, sir. Sir, in the end, I would like to mention here that because of the COVID conditions, we were constrained not to invite the parents. And I have received a numerous number of emails requesting them, and I understand the reason why students kept on this insisting of inviting their parents. But unfortunately, we were not in a position to risk the lives of our dear ones. And that is why we were not able to invite the parents. However, through the graduating students, I would request you to convey my personal congratulations to the parents and my apologies that they were not able to attend this wonderful event and a memorable event. Sir, in the end, I would like to congratulate all the faculty members and especially the graduating students. They have done tremendous work and we have a lot of hope, and they are the people responsible for taking up the future of engineering in this country. Thank you very much.
Who were examined and found qualified for their respective degrees of Bachelor of Civil Engineering along with specialization of Construction Engineering and Petroleum Engineering, to which I pray they may be admitted.
By the virtue of authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of NED University of Engineering and Technology, I admit you to the respective bachelor's degrees and charge you that ever after in your life and in your conversation, you do prove yourself worthy of the same.
I request Professor Dr. Sayyed Amir Iqbal, Dean Mechanical and Manufacturing Engineering, to come and present the recipients of Bachelor degree in Mechanical, Industrial and Manufacturing, Automotive Engineering, Textile Engineering and Textile Sciences. All candidates of Mechanical Engineering, Industrial and Manufacturing Engineering, Automotive Engineering, Textile Engineering and Textile Sciences programs are requested to rise for conferment of their degree.
And Textile Sciences, to which I pray they may be admitted.
By the virtue of authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of NED University of Engineering and Technology, I admit you to the respective bachelor's degrees and charge you that ever after in your life and in your conversation, you do prove yourself worthy of the same.
I request Professor Dr. Saad Ahmed Qazi, Dean, Electrical and Computer Engineering, to come and present the recipients of Bachelor degree in Electrical, Computer Systems, Electronic, Telecommunications and Biomedical Engineering. All candidates of Electrical Engineering, Computer Systems Engineering, Electronic Engineering, Telecommunications Engineering and Biomedical Engineering program are requested to rise for conferment of their degree.
Sir, I present to you the candidates of Batch 2017 who were examined and found qualified for the degrees of Bachelor of Electrical, Computer Systems, Electronic, Telecommunications and Biomedical Engineering, to which I pray they may be admitted.
By the virtue of authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of NED University of Engineering and Technology, I admit you to respective bachelor degrees and charge you that ever after in your life and in your conversation, you do prove yourself worthy of the same.
I request Professor Dr. Muhammad Tufail, Pro Vice Chancellor, to come and present the recipients of Bachelor degree in Chemical, Materials, Polymer and Petrochemical.
Pray they may be admitted.
By the virtue of authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of NED University of Engineering and Technology, I admit you to the respective bachelor's degrees and charge you that ever after in your life and in your conversation, you do prove yourself worthy of the same.
I request Professor Dr. Noman Ahmed, Acting Dean, Information Sciences and Humanities, to come and present the recipients of Bachelor of Software Engineering, Bachelor of Science in Computer Science and Information Technology, Computational Finance, Applied Physics, English Linguistics and Industrial Chemistry degrees. All candidates of Software Engineering, Computer Science, Computational Finance, English Linguistics, Industrial Chemistry and Applied Physics programs are requested to rise for conferment of their degree.
Sir, I present to you the candidates of batch 2017 who were examined and found qualified for their respective degrees of Bachelor of Software Engineering, Bachelor of Science in Computer Science, Bachelor of Science in Computational Finance, English Linguistics, Industrial Chemistry, and Applied Physics, to which I pray they may be admitted.
By the virtue of authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of NED University of Engineering and Technology, I admit you to the respective bachelor's degrees and charge you that ever after in your life and in your conversation, you do prove yourself worthy of the same.
I now request the registrar to come and present the list of candidates for the award of bachelor degrees in absentia.
Sir, I present to you the list of candidates of Bachelor of Engineering in Civil along with the specialization in construction, petroleum, mechanical, textile, industrial and manufacturing, automotive, electrical, computer systems, electronics, telecommunications, biomedical, chemical, materials, polymer and petrochemical, food, metallurgical, software, and Bachelor of Studies in Computer Science and Information Technology, Textile Science, Economics and Finance, Management Science, Computational Finance, Applied Physics, Industrial Chemistry, English Linguistics, and Development Studies, Bachelor.
Sayyeda Narmeen Zehra, second position holder. And Mr. Muhammad Muiz Khan, gold medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and the gold medal. Mr. Muhammad Muiz Khan is also the recipient of Dr. A.T. Khan Memorial Gold Medal, Institution of Engineers Pakistan Gold Medal, and NESPAC Gold Medal, along with the cash prize of Rs. 5,000.
The Chairman, Civil Engineering Department, is again requested to assist the Chief Minister in awarding the gold medal and merit certificates to Bachelor of Civil with Specialization in Construction Engineering position holders. Mr. Khatri Mizan Abban, third position holder, he is awarded with a cash award of Rs. 20,000 from Messrs. Ziauddin Ahmed and Company Private Limited. Ms. Alia Arif, second position holder, she's awarded with a cash award of Rs. 30,000 from Messrs. Ziauddin Ahmed and Company Private Limited. And Mr. Muhammad Mas Sayed, gold medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and gold medal. Mr. Muhammad Mas Sayed is the recipient of gold medal of Institution of Engineers Pakistan and also the gold medal of Messrs. Ziauddin Ahmed and Company Private Limited, along with the cash award of Rs. 50,000. The in charge Petroleum Engineering Department is requested to assist the Chief Minister in awarding the gold medal and the merit certificates to the Bachelors of Petroleum Engineering position holders. Ms. Saman Suhail, third position holder. Ms. Sadak Iqbal, second position holder. And Ms. Nimra Yusuf, gold medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and the gold medal. Ms. Nimra Yusuf is also the recipient of Institution of Engineers Pakistan Gold Medal.
Nahi,
The chairman, Mechanical Engineering Department, is requested to assist the Chief Minister in awarding the gold medal and merit certificates to Bachelor of Mechanical Engineering position holders. Mr. Mohammed Saad, third position holder. Mr. Noor Khan, second position holder. And Mr. Zabid Hussain, gold medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and gold medal. Mr. Zabid Hussain is also the recipient of Indus Motor Company Limited gold medal along with cash prize of Rs. 10,000 and the Institution of Engineers Pakistan gold medal. The Chairman, Automotive and Marine Engineering Department is requested to assist the Chief Minister in awarding the Gold Medal and the Merit Certificates to the Bachelors of Automotive Engineering position holders. Ms. Lehmeen Binte Haider, third position holder, Sheikh Sharjeel Ahmed, second position holder, and Ms. Soha Jameel, gold medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and the gold medal. Ms. Soha Jameel is also the recipient of Institution of Engineers Pakistan gold medal.
Chairperson, Textile Engineering Department is requested to assist the Chief Minister in awarding the gold medal and merit certificates to Bachelor of Textile Engineering position holders. Ms. Sara Kaid Johar, third position holder, Ms. Sidra Akhlaq, second position holder, and Ms. Anam Jabeen, gold medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and gold medals. Ms. Anam Jabeen is also the recipient of Firoz 1888 Mills Limited Laptop and the Institution of Engineers Pakistan Gold Medal. All other position holders are awarded the Firoz 1888 Mills Limited Tablet.
The Chairperson, Textile Engineering Department is requested to assist the Chief Minister in awarding the Gold Medal and the Merit Certificates to the position holders in Bachelors of Science in Textile Sciences Examination. Ms. Fatma Hussain, third position holder, Ms. Sadia Khan, second position holder, and Ms. Daraksha Imam, first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and the Gold Medal. Ms. Daraksha Imam is also the recipient of Firoz 1888 Mills Laptop. All other position holders are awarded the Firoz 1888 Mills Limited Tablets. Thank you.
The Chairman, Industrial and Manufacturing Engineering Department is requested to assist the Chief Minister in awarding the Gold Medal and Merit Certificates to Bachelor of Industrial and Manufacturing Engineering position holders. Ms. Javedia Hussain, third position holder. Ms. Sadia Waseem, second position holder. And Ms. Rabab Hanif, gold medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and gold medal. Ms. Rabab Hanif is also the recipient of Institution of Engineers Pakistan gold medal.
Thank you, Honorable Chief Minister, sir.
Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. Hussain Daud, Chairman Daud Hercules Corporation, is requested to award merit certificates and gold medals.
The Chairman, Electrical Engineering Department, is requested to assist the Chief Guest in awarding the Gold Medal and the Merit Certificates to the Bachelors of Electrical Engineering position holders. Ms. Aisha Khan, third position holder. Ms. Anamta Farooq, second position holder. And Mr. Muhammad Umar, Gold Medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their Merit Certificates and the Gold Medal. Mr. Muhammad Umar is also the recipient of Messrs. Fast Cables Excellence Award of cash prize of Rs. 100,000 and the Institution of Engineers Pakistan Gold Medal. The Chairman, Computer Systems Engineering Department, is requested to assist the Chief Guest in awarding the Gold Medal and Merit Certificates to Bachelor of Computer Systems Engineering position holders. Mr. Ali Raza Qureshi, third position holder. Mr. Mason Yusuf Hayati, second position holder. And Sayyada Iska Atifa Javed, gold medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and gold medal. Sayyada Iska Atifa Javed is also the recipient of Institution of Engineers Pakistan gold medal. The Chairman, Biomedical Engineering Department, is requested to assist the Chief Guest in awarding the Gold Medal and the Merit Certificates to the Bachelors of Biomedical Engineering position holders. Mr. Ali Hamad, third position holder. Ms. Shifa Arif, second position holder. And Mr. Anisur Rahman Hashmi, gold medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and the gold medal. Mr. Anisur Rahman Hashmi is also the recipient of Institution of Engineers Pakistan gold medal.
The Chairman, Electronic Engineering Department is requested to assist the Chief Guest in awarding the Gold Medal and Merit Certificates to Bachelor of Electronics Engineering position holders. Ms. Faryal Zehra, third position holder. Ms. Muntaha Shams, second position holder. And Ms. Maha Tariq, gold medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and gold medal. Ms. Maha Tariq is also the recipient of Institution of Engineers Pakistan gold medal.
The Chairman, Telecommunications Engineering Department is again requested to assist the Chief Guest in awarding the Gold Medal and the Merit Certificates to the Bachelors of Telecommunications Engineering position holders. Ms. Aksa Saleem, third position holder. Ms. Ikra Muskan, second position holder. And Ms. Yumna, Gold Medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their Merit Certificates and the Gold Medal. Ms. Yumna is also the recipient of Institution of Engineers Pakistan Gold Medal.
Chairman, Chemical Engineering Department is requested to assist the Chief Guest in awarding the Gold Medal and Merit Certificates to Bachelor of Chemical Engineering position holders. Mr. Faiz Mohammed Mehboob Khan, third position holder. Mr. Abdul Basit, second position holder. And Mr. Shah Mohammed Hassan, Gold Medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their Merit Certificates and Gold Medal. Mr. Shah Mohammed Hassan is also the recipient of Institution of Engineers Pakistan Gold Medal.
The Acting Chairman, Materials Engineering Department is requested to assist the Chief Guest in awarding the Gold Medal and the Merit Certificates to the Bachelors of Materials Engineering position holders. Ms. Hamna Siddiqui, third position holder. Ms. Aisha Khan, second position holder. And Sheikh Mohammed Zaid, Gold Medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their Merit Certificates and the Gold Medal. Sheikh Mohammed Zaid is also the recipient of Institution of Engineers Pakistan Gold Medal.
The Chairman, Metallurgical Engineering Department is requested to assist the Chief Guest in awarding the Gold Medal and Merit Certificates to Bachelor of Metallurgical Engineering position holders. Ms. Aisha Ehsan, third position holder. Mr. Abdul Wahad, second position holder. And Ms. Ramsha Naveed, Gold Medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their Merit Certificates and Gold Medal. Ms. Ramsha Naveed is also the recipient of Institution of Engineers Pakistan Gold Medal.
The acting chairman, Polymer and Petrochemical Engineering Department is requested to assist the chief guest in awarding the gold medal and the merit certificates to the Bachelors of Polymer and Petrochemical Engineering position holders. Ms. Aisha Naseer, third position holder. Ms. Varda Javed, second position holder. And Ms. Ikra Irfan, gold medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and the gold medal. Ms. Ikra Irfan is also the recipient of Institution of Engineers Pakistan gold medal.
The chairperson, Food Engineering Department, is requested to assist the chief guest in awarding the gold medal and merit certificates to Bachelor of Food Engineering position holders. Ms. Khizra Bakhtiar, third position holder, Ms. Sadia Ahmed, second position holder, and Sayyeda Misbah Hassan, gold medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and gold medal. Sayyeda Misbah Hassan is also the recipient of Institution of Engineers Pakistan gold medal.
The chairperson, Architecture and Planning Department, is requested to assist the chief guest in awarding the gold medal and the merit certificates to the position holders in architecture. Ms. Naila Jabeen, third position holder. Ms. Yusra Sami, second position holder. And Ms. Sawat, gold medalist and first position holder, are requested to receive their merit certificates and the gold medal.
To technical subjects. I'm sure you want some old people like me to come along and give you some advice about life and how to go forward. This is a momentous day, and I want to congratulate each and every one of you. Heartiest congratulations on graduating from this august university. Mubarakah. This is a tipping point in your life. You're going from one world to another. You're going from a world where you're protected, you lived in a controlled environment, and environment that facilitated your growth, particularly in learning and in your technical appreciation of engineering and how that's going to impact life. I don't want to burden you with that. I would rather talk to you about something very simple. And that is that I'm going to give you some insight as to how to apply for a job. Now, there are basically three worlds that we all have, every one of us. There's the world of ourselves, there's the world of our society, our families, our parents, and there's an eternal world. And whenever we make decisions, we're making decisions which impact all three worlds. Now, it is important for us then to be able to make those decisions which will give us success in all three worlds. Most of us concentrate on the second world, which is the temporal world. Some of us also try to concentrate on the first world, which is ourselves and our development of ourselves. And some of us are also convinced that there is an eternal world. Now, when you, as young students, graduated from this Augustine institution, apply for a job, how will you know which university to go to and how you're going to be able to present yourself if you're called for an interview? Well, I'd like to share with you my learnings of life. It just happens that this is my 54th year of service to Pakistan. And I recall when I graduated back in 1966, and the warmth I feel today, I cannot explain. But the important thing is that in those 53, 54 years which I have been working, I have been thinking about, over the last 2 to 4 weeks, on what I would say to you today. And I would say this to you, very short. You want a formula for success in all three worlds? The formula is very simple. It's called truthfulness. We in our organization employ people who are truthful. If we find that somebody who's not truthful, then he cannot be part of our organization. Why? Because with truthfulness, we're able to trust the person. And our organization runs on trust.
Christian Minister for Universities and Boards, Mr. Hussain Daud, Chairman Anglo Corporation, Dr. Sarosh Ashmat Lodi, Vice Chancellor, NED University, faculty of NED University, members of the syndicate, students, especially students who are graduating today, the administration of the university, Assalamu alaikum, and a very good evening. It's indeed an honor for me to be here again at a convocation, the 2021 convocation of NED University. As most of you know, I am an alumni of this university. More than 41 years ago, I came here and have had this bond with this place ever since. One thing which has not changed, a lot of things have changed here at the university. One thing that has not changed is Dr. Sarosh Ashmat Lodi is still here. He was here when I came in 1980. I still see him here. And this being the convocation, I'm sure there are lots of secrets they've not told you. I'm going to tell you some secrets. You see this pond, you know, Dr. Sarosh has on purpose cleaned it up. Otherwise, it used to be filled with dirty water. And the reason that it was filled with dirty water, and the reason that he's cleaned it up today is because there's a tradition that after convocation, the students get together and throw the vice chancellor in that dirty water. So this is a secret that I'm telling you. Last time when I was here, I'd heard the guest speaker at that time, the chief guest at that time, had given a very enlightening speech, though some of people did not like it, but I thoroughly enjoyed it. So coming back here brings back memories, and I want to talk about the chief guest today, Mr. Hussain Daud. The government of Sindh, me being part of the government of Sindh for the last 13 years now, and his company, the Anglo Corporation, have teamed up, and we have created together, obviously they're taking the lead and we supporting them, the best and the foremost public-private partnership that you'd see anywhere in the world. And that is the Sindh Anglo Coal Mining Company, which is undertaking coal mining and which is leading to power manufacture. So it was a pleasure, it's an honor working with Mr. Hussain Daud, and it's an honor sharing the same stage with him today. And the NED University has also contributed there. I thought the Vice Chancellor would mention it, but he told me, Mr. Chaud would like to mention it. The NED University, we tasked it and we've got a university campus, currently a campus of the NED University, the Third Institute of Engineering, Science and Technology in Mithi. And inshallah ta'ala, it will be a full-fledged university where a few years from now, me in whatever capacity if they invite me, would be attending convocation similar to this. So it's, as I said, it's an honor to be on the same stage with Mr. Sandhau. So I graduated long time back. I'll just tell you a bit about myself. I went from here, and the reason I'm telling you this is because at the end of my speech, I'll come back to this part. I went to the second best university in the world, and you know which is the best university in the world. It is NED University. So I went from the best to the second best university in the world. I did my master's. I thought you'd give me that answer yourself. I had to prompt you. Did my master's, came back to Pakistan. I've served in various public and private sector companies, joined politics in 2002, and Allah Ta'ala has been kind. I've come to become the chief executive of this province, and I'm fairly happy with what I've done with my life. But today, it's not about me. It's about you, the 1,905 graduating students who completed their undergraduate year, the 868 who've completed their master's program, and the 18 doctors who've completed their PhD programs. NED has grown. When I was there, there were just three departments. We'd opened the fourth one while we were here. It was just civil, mechanical, and electrical. And computer science had started while we were here. Today, the Vice Chancellor tells me there are 29 departments and faculties. The university has grown. I wish that it grows even further. So today, you should be proud to be graduating from the best university in the world, entering a new phase, as Mr. Hussain Daud was saying. You know, in the United States, they don't call this event a convocation. They call it commencement, because you're commencing into a new phase of your life. From, as Daud Saab said, from a protected environment where you are protected by your families, your parents, protected by the faculty, protected by fellow students, out into the open world where you'll be competing. And there are lessons that you should know. First of all, while going there, please, please never forget, whatever you've achieved today, you've not done it alone. You could not have done it without the hard work, without patience that your parents have put up. So first and foremost, after Almighty Allah, you should thank your parents. Your faculty here, they've put in a lot of hard work in making sure that you graduate and you contribute to this world. The staff at NED University, don't ever forget them. I still remember, I don't know if the canteen is still back there or not. The chowkidars of the university, because without them we would not have graduated. I don't know, there are certain other secrets which I don't want to divulge now, how the chowkidars helped us get graduated from here. Never forget the staff. And also don't forget your colleagues. Each one of you must have helped the other in graduating from here. And when you enter into life, please remember all this. And now you're entering into professional life. Some of you may go and do your master's. Again, enter into an academic situation. Others would start working. Some would work first and then do the master's. But remember what you've learned here, because I remember the 5 years. It was five because the course was 4 years. I took 5.5 years to complete it. The 5.5 years that I spent here were probably the best time of my life. Please remember it like that. One thing I'll just get back. I don't want to, because I told Dr. Sarosh that I need to leave early, and I do have a little time. One thing that you should remember, and I'm just taking forward the concept, the theory that Mr. Hussain Daud gave you. Dr. Sarosh talked about online studies and how students were smart enough to maneuver the online studies. One thing that I learned after I left NED University, and I'll be very, very candid, very frank about it. So when we completed our graduation, before we got our diploma, I got our diploma quite late, but before we got our, even our mark sheets, I don't know, the provisional certificate or whatever, we had to get clearance from each in every department of the university. At that time, I don't know what the rules are now, you were only allowed 2 books from the library. And you had to get a clearance from the librarian, from the head librarian, from his uncle, and everybody. So when I went abroad, went to the US, I'm talking about honesty, talking about being honest. I went to the library of the university that I went to, and I asked them, when I got there for the first time, I saw the books. I've stolen books, if you want to say that. That was a long time ago. So I asked the librarian, the person sitting in front of the counter, and asked them, how many books can I borrow at a time? And the girl there, she looked at me, and the answer was, as many as you can carry. So by the time I finished my degree, I had about 50 books from the library in my room. I was packing, putting my own books together into boxes to take back to Pakistan, and I was tempted. Because I'd got my degree, the commencement had taken place, everything was done, I was flying in 3 or 4 days. And I was tempted to keep these 50 books and pack them along with my other stuff so that I can ship them back to Pakistan. But then I remembered at that time that they trusted me. Nobody is here. In order to get my degree, I had to go to this mechanical workshop on this side and get a certificate saying that I've not broken any tools and there's nothing due against me. I had to go to the electrical workshops and get clearance from there. But they gave me my degree, and they asked me, without asking questions. So what I did was, remember, past midnight, I took all those books, all 50 of them, almost 50, I don't remember the exact number, obviously. Went to the library at midnight. You could return the books at any time. It was just a drop box. So opened up the drop box and dropped all 50 books there. The other thing that I wanted to tell you was, we talked about online studies here, there was an honor code. When you took exams, you had to sign that honor code, and the honor code simply said that you're going to be honest, you're going to do your own work, and you're not going to get help from anybody else. When we used to go to take our exams, the teacher would come and he'll hand over the question paper and he'll leave the room. And then you were at liberty also to leave the room. you just had to come back 3 hours later and drop your answer book. The teacher would not even be there. Drop your answer book into a box, and that was it. So that was the level of trust. And the story that comes to mind, there was one subject that I was taking at that time, structural dynamics. So the professor, who was a retired professor at that time, he'd written a new book. He came back to the university to teach this course. And as I told you, I am a book lover, and I had all books. So he had written a book on statics of structures, and then subsequently he wrote a book on dynamics. And the exam was, the course that I was taking was dynamics. So I had the statics book, and one or two problems from the final exam were from the statics book, and you were allowed, it was an open book exam, you were allowed to take books with you. And it helped me solve that problem. So the statics part was done, I just had to complete the dynamics part. Just right behind me was a fellow Pakistani student who, during this time, was having trouble with the exam. What I did was I opened that book to the page where the half the problem was solved. While going out, I finished the exam about 20 or 25 minutes before time. So before going out of the class, what I did was I kept that book, opened it up on the page that had the, you know, half the answer, and I put it on his desk and I left the room. Obviously, I couldn't talk to him. This was a violation of the honor code. And, you know, when this friend of mine who went on to become, you know, also attained the peak of his service wherever he was, I don't want to mention that, he came out and he told me, Urdu mein, kaha yaar kya aapne pareshan ho gaye the exam mein, aap apni kitab bhul ke aa gaye udhar. So he didn't even think that somebody would be trying to help him. And he, as I said, I am grateful to Almighty Allah for giving me all the success. And this friend of mine had also reached, he's retired now, he'd reached the peak of his service. He got the best possible post that he could get in his service. So honesty and hard work pays. You worked hard here. Be honest. Be loyal to whatever organization that you're working for, and inshallah ta'ala you will succeed in life. So once again, congratulations to all the students who graduated today. It's indeed a proud moment for you. I wish all and each and every one of you the best in your lives. But as I said, be truthful, be honest, and Allah will definitely grant you the best. Thank you very much. Pakistan Zindabad.
We would request the Honorable Chief Minister to please stay on the stage to receive the souvenir from the Vice Chancellor, NED University, Dr. Sarosh Hashmat Lodi.
We now request the Honorable Vice Chancellor, NED University of Engineering and Technology, Dr. Sarosh Hashmat Lodi, to present the souvenir to the Honorable Chief Minister, Mr. Murad Ali Shah. Chief Guest Mr. Hussain Daud, Chairman Daud Hercules Corporation, is requested to please come and receive the souvenir from the Vice Chancellor, Dr. Sarosh Hashmat Lodi. Pro-Chancellor Mr. Muhammad Ismail Rahul,
is now requested to please come and receive the souvenir from the Vice Chancellor, Dr. Saroj Hashmat Lodi. Thank you, sir. Professor Dr. Saad Ahmed Qazi is requested to lead the convocation prayer. Ladies and gentlemen, you are now requested to rise for the convocation prayer.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Praise and glory belongs to Allah Almighty, who has accepted the endeavors, hard work and dedication of the seekers of knowledge and crowned them with success. And blessings be on his last prophet, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who has directed every Muslim to attain knowledge. O Allah, you yourself has stated that, say my Lord, improve me in knowledge. Surah Taha, verse 114. Complying with this very commandment, we ask you to augment our knowledge and make it beneficial for all of us in both the worlds. We seek your refuge from non-beneficial knowledge. May Allah make the recipients of the degrees worthy of the honor conferred upon them. May Allah enable them to serve humanity at large and serve our beloved country through the knowledge gained by them. We also pray that they attain not only remarkable success in this world, but also enjoy high position in the life hereafter, as it is the main aim of education. O Allah, let these boys and girls realize the importance of education and know that the acquisition of knowledge is incumbent upon each male and female, and that it is the source of success for worldly life and the life hereafter. O Allah, inculcate in their hearts the determination to value the knowledge they have gained through the guidance of their teachers and the sacrifices of their parents. They must keep in mind that the secret of success lies in high standards of ethics and good moral behavior and showing respect to parents, teachers, and elders. O Allah, endow these graduates with qualities of truthfulness, humility, simplicity, social service, and patriotism, and above all, consciousness of the Almighty, as these are the ultimate objectives of knowledge, which places them on the highest level of the best of creatures. May they be wise enough to recognize their weaknesses and enable them to capitalize their strengths to overcome their weaknesses. May Allah make them courageous enough to acknowledge their mistakes and learn from them. O Allah, we pray that this spark of faith and knowledge kindled in their hearts may enlighten further lights and be transmitted to succeeding generations as well. And let not the knowledge gained by them be restricted to only their own benefits. O Allah, shower your blessings on them and give them success in whatever fields they go, and fill their hearts with a feeling of piety and sincerity to Allah. Our Lord, give us good in this world and good in the hereafter, and save us from the punishment of fire. May Allah shower blessings on your best creature, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and all of his family and his companions. And the end of our call is, praise be to Allah, the Lord of all the worlds. Amen.
We now request the Honorable Pro Chancellor to declare the 30th convocation session to close.
I declare the convocation 2021 closed.
Ladies and gentlemen, the academic session will now be on.
Yeah.
ठीक है सर।